Bison are the largest land mammal in North or South America. Wood bison are. Plains bison are close second. The big bulls get to be well over a ton, and the cows are around 1,000 pounds as adults. They have hair that's a lot different than a moose or caribou. You know, moose and caribou and sheep have hollow hair that's real brittle and stuff. Bison hair is really soft and kind of curly and kind of woolly. I'm Tom Seaton, the Wood Bison Project biologist, and we're in Shagelok, Alaska. I am studying the wild wood bison population, the only wild wood bison population in the United States.
It's a new subject for us, teaching about bison. We're learning it as we go as well.
They've been the most prominent mammal on the Alaska landscape for about the last 500,000 years. You know, it was steppe bison for a long time, and then just, you know, wood bison only came around about the last 10,000 years. They're really common, which is kind of interesting that our written history in our time now is one of the few times in history when bison weren't in Alaska.
There were hunter on here. No, there was none before. Maybe a really long time ago. Maybe, I don't know. Yeah.
Well, there was 130 released in April through June of 2015, and now it's May of 2016, so about a year ago. We had some die and some born, but we're back at about 130 again. Most of interior Alaska is boreal forest, so just have a mix of spruce and cottonwood and birch and willow. It's wooded almost everywhere, but as you get into the Innoko area, you see the country become more open and grassy and lots of sedge. There's hundreds of square miles of sedge and grass habitat. It's really quite a sight to behold, especially when you fly along and see a group of bison in the middle of one of the meadows. Well, the only access we have to this country is by air. And so with an airplane, we have antennas on each wing. A lot of the animals have collars on them. Collars emit a beep once a second, and so we listen for that beep. In the airplane, we can listen to one antenna or both. And so if we hear the signal on both antennas, that means we're headed right for it. If it's on just on one antenna, it means that the bison's off to the right. So we turn the airplane to head toward the bison. And so once we track a bison, we try to record, you know, who they're with, and then we try to see, you know, if anybody has died, or if any bison have died, or if any have been born, and what they're eating, what sort of habitats they're liking, things like that. One of the main reasons to reestablish this herd is for conservation of the species, but for the common person, there's not a lot of value in conserving a particular wild animal that's not doing that well. What increases the value to the common person is their ability to use and participate with that animal in the ecosystem. And so hunting is a way that extremely increases the value of animals to the common person. And so hunting at some point will be a part of the management of this herd. And that's really an honorable thing that you know, people will eventually enjoy, you know, participating with this prey animal as a prey animal.
You know, we're just gonna have to keep an eye on them. You know, if they're successful, we're gonna have to come up with a management plan.
We'd all figure out how to butcher a bison. That's not going to be an issue. I don't think there'll be much of a learning curve. We subsist and hunt everything that's there, and wood bison will be different, and we'll have to learn some of their characteristics, and we're already figuring out some of that stuff.
When I look into the future, I try to think of examples, you know, how did the past go as far as, you know, how the future might go. And I look at moose, and in Western Alaska, there wasn't moose 100 years ago. There's a lot of accounts, both from native elders and early explorers, that there wasn't a lot of moose. But if you look at it now, that the people in Western Alaska are closely tied to moose. Their moose are a big part of their diet and their culture. So when I look at bison, I think, well, if people adopted moose so quickly, I can see the same thing with bison. There's a lot of potential that, you know, 100 years from now, bison could be just as much a part of the food supply and culture of people as moose is now.
They must taste good. They eat grass. Yeah. They taste good, I guess. Yeah. I don't know.